former refugee becomes CEO and develops video games to promote world peace.
Before we begin, do us a favor and click that like button. Also subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell to be inspired by these inspiring stories every day.
War was all Luol Mayan knew as a boy. Growing up, he and the other child refugees were accustomed to being hungry and bombs falling from the sky. Luol was born on the way out of war-torn South Sudan. His parents fled more than 200 miles to a refugee camp in northern Uganda with baby Luol and his sisters, who tragically died of illness before they arrived. There, Luol spent the first 22 years of his life dreaming of peace. Luol was 12 years old when he saw a laptop for the first time at a registration station for the refugee camp. He was so amazed, he thought it had come straight from heaven. His mother, Nyanyet Daruka, thought he was joking when he started asking for one. She could barely feed her family as it was. But then, she thought, it might empower her son to do greater things. At the very least, it would be a nice distraction from the camp. So she saved for 3 years and bought Luol a laptop for $300 in 2013. He was so grateful, he broke down in tears. As there was no electricity in the camp, Luol made regular 3-hour trips to an internet cafe. All that walking was well worth the effort, though, as Luol discovered the captivating world of video games. But more important, he realized their potential. He could harness that power to do good for his home country and the rest of the world. With his mother's gift, Luol went on to teach himself English. He also learned programming, graphic design, and started his company, Janoob Games. There, in the camp, he developed his first game, Salam, meaning peace in Arabic. The initial version was a mobile game about protecting communities from the destruction of war. Players dissolve bombs falling from the sky with a tap of the finger, saving their villages. Luol's fellow refugees were among the first to test his game, and it was a hit. After all, it was modeled after their lives at camp. And when Luol shared a link to it on Facebook, Salam went viral in gaming communities across the world. Luol was invited to speak at a game conference in South Africa. That opened the door to serving as a consultant for the World Bank and eventually being granted a G visa. He moved to Washington, D.C., where he's been working on the latest version of Salam. The new game puts the player into a refugee's shoes. On their journey to a better life, they must dodge bombs and gather enough food and water to survive. When a player's energy points run out, they have to option to buy more resources with actual money, which the company then uses to benefit living refugees. Luol hopes to not only build empathy by showing players what life is like for a refugee, but to teach and encourage conflict resolution. That's the thing in life, the 24-year-old told the Washington Post. If you're going through something hard and you survive, the next thing is, how do you come out of that better? How do you utilize that opportunity to make your life better? From a refugee to a founder and CEO of Janoob Games, Luol has come a long way, but he's nowhere near finished, not until he helps the world find peace. Learn more about the game and check out sneak peeks in the video. Luol plans to have it released by December, so share to spread the word. The world is filled with stories going viral every single day. But how many of these sites can you actually follow? We understand that your day should start with positive stories, stories that resonate with you. And so we started JoJo Stories. Our mission is to create meaningful stories that cover everything from animals to anthropology, history to environment and lifestyle. The kind of content you read on our site will be one you'll want to share with your family and friends. We hope you'll join our growing family and be part of our community. Welcome to JoJo Stories. JoJoStories.com.